for next technical session on the topic information technology. We have with us CA Narasimhan Elangovan to present on the topic, and I request CA Priyanka to kindly escort our speaker onto the desk. I also request Priyanka to kindly welcome our speaker by presenting the floral bouquet. Thank you. To briefly introduce, CA Narasimhan Elangovan is practicing chartered accountant and an information system assurance professional, partner of KEN and Chartered Accountants, Bangalore. He is an international speaker on IS insurance, data analytics, cyber security, forensic audit, and data privacy laws. He specializes in data analytics, risk-based audit, internal audit, information technology, consulting, and many other topics. And his youngest visa faculty, youngest speaker at ISAGA, Asian Pacific Conference at Dubai in 2017 and at Bangkok in 2018, and has cleared CISA exams among top 20% of the world in ranking. He is currently a coach, mentor, trainer, author, and presented various seminars of information system audit, COVID-5, Digital India, data analytics, cyber security to more than 7,000 members at various levels. For the benefit of the CA community and to make information systems more practical, he has launched multiple courses online along with practical examination tips. With this very brief introduction, I welcome you to the seminar. So, over to you.
We are always similar. Or rather, students' approach in technology, or not where technology works. A student will go blank right at the time when he enters the exam hall. Same way when technology is supposed to work, it will stop working. Correct? And coincidentally, I'm a speaker on technology. Alright, so thank you, Divya, for introducing me. I handle one of the most feared subjects, which is called as ISCA IT Enterprise Information System, whatever name called. Whatever may be the name, common feature is why should I study this subject? First problem. Second problem is there are so many things which we can do. Of all things we are sitting and studying, what is a computer, what is a network, what are these things? I'll give you a couple of stories before I get started into the subject and while the logistics are being set up. I ordered one product, I think it was a portable charger on Amazon. All of us do online shopping, correct? Okay. So I ordered one portable charger on Amazon.com, and when I ordered, obviously I was excited to receive the order. A couple of days later, I got a message in the evening, your order has been delivered. But to my surprise, actually I didn't get the order. I called up my family and checked with them, did you get anything? Everybody said no. So obviously I was frustrated. I immediately went to Amazon.com and I placed a request over there saying that I have not received the order. Within half an hour, Amazon.com returned the money to me. I was happy. Money came back. Next day morning, I got a portable charger delivered by the courier boy. I was only thinking, I should have ordered an Apple iPhone instead of that particular portable charger. Justice. In other words, this is what the reality is. We are running through. In and around us, there are so many number of systems which are running there. And these are all technology driven. The hard fact is, you learn all the auditing standards, you learn all the income tax law, you learn accounting entries to what you do on audit software. Any questions? Some technical issue, we'll get that sorted. So the hard reality is what? We are all auditing systems. We are all auditing software. Which means, as a CA student, our approach of writing this paper and approach of answering this has to differ compared to the rest of the papers. You might think that, sir, why is this paper theoretical? Can't it be made practical? That is the reason you have certain add-on courses during the course of your internship or your articleship. But without knowing the theory, you cannot become a professional. Alright, so that is the first thing which you have to appreciate. Second, when we say systems, remember any system has three basic principles. Input, process, output. Any system in the world. It may be IBM Watson, which is an artificial intelligence, or Siri, which says, okay Siri, tell me what is the time, or tell me, or you know, order some food from Swiggy. Or for all you know, your Excel sheet, which day in and day out we keep on opening and working. Everything has these three fundamental principles. If you have an understanding of these three, any sort of a system, any sort of a process, you will be able to audit or understand. Are you clear with this? Now the way I am going to structure this session, or you know, have the discussion is, we are going to have three parts, because I was told that this is a session common for IPCC as well as CA final. Correct? So can I just know the demographic, how many of them are CA final? Because CA final you have a deadly paper called ISCA. I'll address those questions, a few of them. And then we have the CA intermediate, which is the new scheme. New scheme. Okay? And CA IPCC, the old scheme. Okay, looks like old scheme, we have the majority of them. Fair enough. Okay. While that is on one side, the other thing which you have to also keep in mind is, this examination onwards is a big boon for you, especially in this paper of information technology. You know, drawing reference from what Vikas sir was also making mention, remember he was telling that, you know, retired professors or you know, teachers who have any experience are collecting the papers, which is a likely scenario even in the case of papers like information system monitoring. Which means, in a case of an MCQ, there cannot be a possible answer. It is either the right answer or wrong answer. Of course, in institute context, we have three answers. Right answer, wrong answer, institute answer. So if you write the right answer, you may get the marks. Institute answer, you will get the marks. Wrong answer, obviously, you know what it is. Correct? And sometimes these MCQ are like, you know, that China phone models. Everything looks the same. Every option looks the same. You are not able to figure out what is the difference, correct? So we have a few tips also which I will be addressing on how to crack that perspective, alright? So while this is being set up, any general questions you have, the way on which you want me to address, I can cater or you know, answer a few of your general questions, then I will go to specifics. Any questions? Yes sir? Please sir, no problem. Okay, that is covered as a part of it. You will have to just wait a little, I will speak on that. Covering, what I have also done is a few past examination questions along with the answers written by students. You know, the answer paper itself, I have taken a screenshot. Okay, from the student only, I didn't go to ICA and take it. Alright, so in an authorized manner, I went and got these question papers. You know, I have put them. I will tell you how you should write and very important how you should not write. But the rule of thumb is, answer only in bullet points. That is the rule of thumb. Answer only in bullet points. And before answering anything in bullet points, you will have to give a small paragraph. For example, they ask you, what is business continuity planning? Then give a small paragraph which says, business continuity planning refers to dot dot dot. The following are the features of BCP. So rule number one is what? When you are answering, give a small paragraph, and after that, please write on bullet points. Are you material, top it up with practice manual. Practice manual is more like revision. Your revision cannot be the first preparation. And unfortunately, this paper, for whatever reason, is the sixth or seventh paper in the syllabus. Sixth in the case of CA final, seventh in the case of your old syllabus IPCC. Okay, and I think seventh both in case of intermediate. And seventh paper, you are already in relaxed mode. First paper was in full vibration mode, tension. Face to face, everything was vibrating and you are going to exam out. By last paper, you got frustrated and that is normally reflected in the results. I hope you understood why this paper is that way, right? I think to some extent I have answered that question. Let's quickly look into it, slightly on the lighter note. How is the ISCA important to a CA student and just typically how he sees it? Correct? So you have to pass this. As though this is not enough, we have one more thing to target. You know, that's an unfortunate, but this is the reality, you have to face it. Correct? And this is typically how systems are evolved over a point in time. Just understand this, you will understand what the context is. I'm not sure if it will play because of the settings. Let me try my best. If it does, you are lucky. Otherwise, I'll share the YouTube link. Okay, so probably I'll play it a little later. Nothing to worry. Let's come into the concrete thing. A few general tips. The paper structure, if you look into it, broadly is under these two buckets: technical concepts, general management. When I say general management, yeah, it will talk about a lot of things like, you know, what are the benefits, what is the advantage of ERP, what are the benefits of bringing a automated system. Those are all general, you will be able to write it on your own. When you have the technical concepts, you need to spend extra time there. Very, very crucial. I'll speak about specific chapters also when I'm speaking about it. Whereas if it's general management, some bit of your story writing skills, couple it with some bit of common sense, I'm sure you'll be able to do justice there. Few basic steps. A chain is as strong as its weakest link. I heard somebody saying that, you know, I got more than 150 or 200, but ITSM I got 39. Happened with your circle, known circle, friends, etc. Correct? The biggest problem is we try to neglect this paper. So a chain is as strong as its weakest link. So remember from now on, ISCA or ITSM is your strongest paper. Invest in that. Alright? Next. Do not panic. It is an extended form of common sense. Why do I say this? Every topic which you read in the ITSM related to what you see in an ROT. For example, when I take classes, I make a mention. Database structure. Or you have something called as a three-tier application architecture. Two-tier application architecture, front-end, back-end. What is this? Your WhatsApp, you take as example. In a WhatsApp, can you see a photo from front? You can go to WhatsApp, click on that, chat history, you can see the photo. Can you also go to gallery and see the photo? Yes. What you saw, the first method was front-end. What you did in the second method is back-end. Which is more convenient for you to view, easily understand? Front-end. Because you know what is the conversation. But if you have to go to the back end, you have to start searching, oh, this day, this people, this person. That is why a front end is easy for the user to understand. A back end is easy for the system to understand. I'll get the difference. That is how you have to start related. In fact, what I normally suggest is, in the left hand side of your material, whichever handouts you are using, my handouts or your handouts or whatever you have, left hand side, please write only examples to remember it. Remember the example, you will be able to do that. And this is a management technique, you know, all these top management gurus in large universities or across the globe, they speak only about this. This is called as photographic memory technique or story writing skills. Remember anything with a story, automatically you will be able to do. In fact, I remember forex futures and forward with the help of Ramayana. Because Ramayana was taught to me way back in school, I remember that story, I have seen that serial and all those things. Based upon that, I used to remember. I used to see Endine movie or Robo movie, I used to link it with the subject. Link whatever you read and hear and see to the subject. You will never forget it. We all know what is the last movie scene in the case of Three Idiots. We all know what happened in the last scene on Lagan or Chakde India or whatever is the latest movie. Why? It is one stronger influence. linked those sort of a topic with the subject. Next, being an IDR, you should pass, you need not panic about it. And don't think too much, especially this is a one strategy, one big problem I've seen with students. Especially on the last day, because this is the last day paper, they start thinking, okay, what should I do after exam? Which movie should I go? Which theater should I go? Which girlfriend goes home I should go? All those things. And often people are thinking which boyfriend also should go. Thanks to Supreme Court order. Correct? So things are, you know, very, very dicey. Forget it. Just to focus on that 7 days. Because most of the time, please understand, a test match, in case you have seen a cricket match, those of you you know, follow and have seen a cricket match, first day and second day, everybody will play well. Third day and fourth day, you will see the fatigue and tiredness. And fifth day, if somebody is able to survive, you say he is actually a test batsman. And that's exactly what has happened for you guys. T20 one day of international over, first three exams over. But until the last, you have to survive, test batsman. Remember, Rahul Dravid is the best in that. So you have to be consistent. Alright? Next, very, very crucial, draw diagrams. Draw diagrams, wherever possible, draw diagrams. It may be a land, it may be star topology, ring topology, mesh topology, or if you are looking at CA final, you have certain things like, you know, system development life cycle. The same thing, draw it in a diagram, try to present your answer in a different way. Correct? It will catch the attention and who knows, for that some more marks may be given. Next, especially for ITSM or EIS, you will have to answer 2 papers in 3 hours time. Please be aware, please be very careful. 2 papers, 3 hours time. Sir, if I answer 2 hours, 1 paper, 1 hour, 1 paper, that's all your choice. Let it not be a scene of Mr. Bean which you have seen. That 2 papers were given and he realized that there was 1 more paper in the last minute. Alright, have a watch over time. And the general principle is very, very simple. Time management, hundreds of lessons can be taught. One simple method. First 1 hour, 30 marks you have to finish. Second 1 hour, 65 marks. Balance 1 hour, you already know what it is. The also reason is, first 1 hour, you will also understand what you write. Paper who is correcting, that fellow also will understand what you write. Second 1 hour, you will understand what you write. That fellow who is correcting, he will not understand. Third 1 hour, nobody will understand. That is the beauty of exam. So you need to ensure you present your answer very, very neat and clear. Please be careful. Alright? Have a watch over. Next. After each chapter, understand the purpose. You know, before you start or after you start, what is the crux of this chapter? And for that, I'll give you one simple tip. In your study material, if you see, there are scopes 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4. Maximum, there will be 8 or 10 topics in the entire chapter. Think, what is that chapter? This is what is called photographic memory technique. Okay, 10 points are covered in this chapter. For example, I am speaking about information system controls or application controls. 6 things they speak about. General controls, 4 things they speak about. Mind map it. And your mind map in such a way it should be that it should work like a mobile. When you click a link, what happens? A new message pops up. When you say back, it goes back to the main one. Have you seen that? That's exactly how you should be able to relate it. Okay, these are the topics, this is what I mean. And every word you cannot remember like this, it is not possible. But remember the broad headers. Next, try to relate the topic with practical experience, what you see and hear daily. Read the summary after every chapter. This is a very important tip. Summary after every chapter. And sometimes you also have glossary. In the materials, you have something called as glossary. They are a rich source of 1 mark and 2 mark questions. And trust me, my dear friends, 1 mark and 2 mark questions have saved so many students. Because you have to write only 3 or 4 pointers. That's more than sufficient, and they are looking at those keywords. And please do not think for 2 marks, they are not give 2 marks. It is possible, I'll show you with answer papers. Alright, a few special strategies. After preparing every 1 chapter, quickly prepare a small summary or a sort of a ready reference guide. Read the glossary, I think I might mention. Yeah, this is one pro strategy. In fact, I didn't tell this, my student only came back and said. Anywhere you see in the material, the following are the types of, and some 3 points or 4 bullet points. Before that 4 or 5 bullet points, read the prior sentence. That is an examination question. I repeat my statement. Anywhere in the material you find 3 or 4 points, please refer 3 or 4 points prior to the day, 1 or 2 sentences. Please read that. That is the examination question. And now I will have to change my strategy other way around. Wherever you see 3 points or 4 points in your study material, that is now an MCQ question. If you see 3 points, the point which is missing is the answer in the exam. I repeat my statement. You see 3 points, those 3 points will be put on the examination paper. Fourth, some random thing they put it on the exam paper. That fourth so-called missing point which was there in your material is the answer in exam. For example, which is not a type of a control? Preventive, detective, corrective, legal. In your material, if you see anywhere, preventive, detective, corrective, there is a legal where are they say? Are they say anywhere? Clear? Next. Always remember to read topics with 4 to 8. ISCA, CA final, even if you have 8 bullet points, please read it because it could be a rich source for 8 mark questions. Okay. When you have more than 10 points, remember only 10 points. Why? Maximum they can ask you is an 8 mark question in ISCA, 6 marks question or 8 marks question in CA IBC. Sir, then why to remember 10 points? 2 points extra, reserve for bandits. In exam hall, you will forget. So therefore, reserve, you need to keep a provision. And please write minimum, if there is asked for 4 marks, write 1 or 2 points extra. But it has to be relevant. Just for the sake of writing, don't write. Okay? This is something which many students ask. Sir, do we have to memorize? Do we have to mug up? There are 2 views of it. I will not go there. I will talk about very practically. Whatever heading is there in institute material, try to influence. Explanation, you have the freedom. That is why I say, try to give all the bullet points, typically giving a heading. Meaning, you first write an answer, the form. You remember, I told you BCP. BCP means, or give a small overview, the following are the features of BCP. A, it is adopted by the management, write an explanation. It is approved by the board or approved by the line management manager, write the features. Next, answer only in bullet points, no serial number. Do not write 1, 2, 3, write bullet point, arrow mark, dot, whatever your MS Word has got various things, you can write there. Okay, why not the serial number? 4 marks question, you knew only 3 points. You have written 1, 2, 3, it is very much evident that you have written only 3 points. But who knows the third point you wrote until the end of next page? Probably he was very happy that day. He wanted to do some charity. He gave you extra half mark. That half mark would make a big difference. Give a small intro prior to starting any answer. This is what I told you. My friend was asking. Mnemonic form. What is a mnemonic form? Short form. A short form. For example, if you are talking about types of control. I use the word PDC, preventive, detective, corrective. If you are talking about types of application controls, so I use the word BIC, POD, bicycle, iPod. Boundary control, input control, communication control, output control, processing control, database control. BIC, POD. Like that, try to create short forms wherever possible, but don't keep on creating short forms. Okay, this is also something if you are doing a group study, some people have a habit. You can probably create some sort of rough questions, probably if interested. And list of topics, I think I have already spoken about this. Yeah, this is an example of a list of topics. This you will find it in your CA intermediate new syllabus, they themselves have done it. But this comes in the beginning of the chapter. My suggestion is, this is an example of mind mapping. Do not go by what institute is given, you guys prepare. So if you take up chapter 3, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, that is what should be reflected. So the topic, the chapter will speak about 5 concepts or 6 concepts, that will be reflected. Then you will start speaking about under that one topic, headers. So this way you do, it becomes all the more easier. Okay? Yeah. This is something which I wanted to specifically emphasize. MCQ from May 2019 exam. And all of us are aware, old IPCC, new IPCC, you have ITSM. Please note they have given a weightage of 30% objective, 70% descriptive. Which means 30% is for a 100 marks paper. ITSM, each of the papers is 50 marks and 50 marks. So you can expect 15 marks to be objective type. And my humble request, I am talking about intermediate. CA final discard, entire 30 marks will be objective. My humble request to all of you is, try to attack this. It is easy. I'll speak about a few strategies. And the best part about this is a little later I'll tell you. Okay, so this is how, you know, they have the categorization. Just wanting to draw a reference, they say some amount will be comprehension and knowledge, some amount will be analysis. Don't bother about all these percentage. And don't sit and validate this in exam also. This is only to tell you, they will ask you concept oriented question, they will also ask you application oriented question. Alright, how do we differentiate? I'll take a few samples and explain. Yeah, most important, an MCQ can also be having 2 marks. This is an interesting thing. Alright, this would be the nature of MCQ carrying 1 mark or 2 mark. So this is what is a very interesting thing. And when you are writing the answer, please write the option along with whatever it is said. Do not just write option C. Alright, I think sir also was making a mention, because this is what we have seen. It is always recommended you write the entire thing. And some people will think that in the question paper only have to tick it. No. Question paper will be with you. And yes, by any for your information, if you tick in the question paper, it is considered as a malpractice. Alright, so never mention anything in the question paper. You get one hall ticket somewhere in the month of April or May. After the end of the hall ticket, there will be 2 pages examination guidelines. Please read it. Alright, please read it. On the day of exam, no. Much before that. Okay? So, 1 mark MCQs will be in the range of 10 to 16. 2 mark MCQs in the range of 7 to 10. So, I hope you are getting a clarity. This ITSM paper, at the same time, ISCA paper, you can expect both of these. So when I say 10 to 16, in case of information technology or AIS, it will become 5 to 8. And here it will be 3 to 5. Right? 50 marks. And this is a beautiful thing. Those of you who came from the CPT background, correct? You used to have this. And the CPT people have a habit. They used to sit and color. Suddenly they will see all answers coming C, 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 C. Now next question I am doubtful, C, R, D, R, C, R, D, R. 3 questions C, therefore this has to be D. Don't do Adhika Prasanga in exam. Alright? Because all these things are very petty things, this will actually get your mind away. Alright? And knowledge and analysis. MCQ will be compulsory. Very important, you have to answer MCQ. Alright? Because it's a compulsion. And no reasoning is required, at least in the May 19th, you'll have a subsequent exam how it's going. Okay? So, how do I answer MCQ question? Can I say that? You know, I think sir also spoke about a few very interesting things. You know, what is that? Whatever, those fancy names, it's just not happening to me once again. Long ago, I was a student as well. And it's kind of bad. So, a test in which it has multiple, one scenario, there is only one correct option. Very simple. One option is correct, rest all you know for all possible reasons it is incorrect. Easily choose. Second thing, all options seems to be correct, but you have to choose the most relevant. This is what they will try to confuse you with. And that is where you need to very carefully observe few words in the question. The first word you have to very, very carefully observe in the question is any negative connotation. Example, not. It is not there. Isn't there. Not available. Which of the following is not a feature? Very important, the negative connotation will have to observe. Second, wherever you find those other options given, try to see which is the most relevant, best, optimal. And that you should apply in the scenario, not based on your personal scenario. Look from a larger company perspective. Don't think small company, how will they be able to approve? No. Think from the largest of the companies, how they will be able to approve. Alright? So normally there is something called as a stem, and there are a few distractors, and then you have a correct answer. Typically, you know, something like this. Which color is the sky? So what are they trying to test you? They are trying to test your knowledge. Correct? And they give you various options, and of course one is the actual answer, and others are distractors. Correct? So try to do the elimination approach. Also, as I told you, best answer, you know which is the best answer, you go ahead and answer it. One more type is where you will have to identify an analogy, relationship. You know, higher inherent risk. An auditor will get a comfort by increasing audit procedures, sampling techniques, etc., etc. So that's a relationship. Next is a reserve. Student is asked to select incorrect response. This is also called as a negative connotation. You know, choose the odd man out. And last is one correct answer. This is a very simple approach. Very important thing in an MCQ, most of them make a mistake is they do not read the entire question. Please do not do that. Read the entire question, please. First, answer it in your mind. Don't directly, okay, option C only, option D only. No. Please answer it in your mind. Eliminate wrong answers. Most importantly, remember long back we had this Kon Banega Crore Pati? KBC style of questions, correct? We had the 50-50 option. So always eliminate. And generally, in 4 answers, look at the fellow who is setting the question paper. He will first write one of them as the right answer. One more, he will give exactly opposite answer. Exactly opposite. You know, sun rises in the east. He will first write that. Which is exactly opposite to the west. Then he will give you something called as distractor. He will give something called as distractor. Which looks similar, but not similar. Northeast. Maybe you are in North Pole, it might happen. Example. And something which is unrelated at all. Why? He is running out of options. He has to give 4 options. He is running out of options, so he will give some random thing. So that random thing is first you have to eliminate. Second, eliminate the exact opposite. And then you will be left with, that's so called 50-50, you will have to make a careful choice between. Okay? Use the process of elimination. Select the best answer. Best, first, most preferred, most optimal, etc. Because I answered an examination called Certified Information System Auditor, correct? All the marks in the question or in the question paper, all of them had 4 correct answers. You have to choose the best answer. And a best answer in a scenario might differ. In a SME, there might be a different scenario. In a corporate, there might be a different scenario. So you have to apply your analytical engine. Answer the question, you know the first. And of course, make an educated guess when you have no other option. Let's quickly look into sample questions. FYI, in the institute website, they have hosted a few sample questions for EIS and IT. My humble request, if you are in intermediate or old syllabus or new syllabus, doesn't matter, pick up both of them and read. Because anyways, you will not get to know which is out of syllabus, but you still read. Alright? Please read, because I was going through it, you know, last evening. I found that institute itself has repeated EIS question in IT, IT questions in EIS. So to the extent what they have repeated, they will not repeat in exam. I hope you understood my strategy. That means whatever is not repeated, they may probably ask in your examination. So please be careful that EIS folks, please read IT questions, only MCQ, not other syllabus, only MCQ. IT folks, please read EIS. In addition, RTP May 2019 has got excellent set of MCQ questions, at least 5 or 6 or 10 to get started with. And generally the trend is RTP questions are normally asked. Okay? Yeah, let's look into a simple question. It's not very complicated. Even if you have not studied also, you will be able to answer. That is where the big advantage is. Conceptual knowledge you should have. During an audit of financial transaction at enterprise XYZ, it was found that simple errors of data entry were occurring when 2 digits that were either individual or part were reversed. You are passing an entry 385, instead of that you pass it at 583. Happens when you are finalizing accounts, your balance sheet never tallies, etc., etc. So which are the following? Is it an addition? Have I added a new number? Truncation. What is truncation? Cutting it. Is it truncation? No. Substitution? Transposition. Substitution, this is where I told you, addition will not be there at all. Because what they have said, the digits were reversed or interchanged. So this is not the answer, remove it. Next, truncation. Truncation is, can I say not relevant? This is exactly opposite of what is the necessary. Then I told you 2 confusing options will be there. Substitution or transposition. Now what is a substitution? Writing one digit instead of another digit. Instead of 3, I always write 4. Or instead of 3, I always write 8 because I accidentally place my hand a little above the mouse pad. That is called substitution. Transposition is second digit making it third digit making it second. So what is the answer? I hope you understood the strategy. Alright? Let's quickly look into one other question. Which of the controls are responsible for maintaining a chronology of events from the time a sender dispatches a message till the time a person receives the message? Yes, please. Answers. CA final also can answer because it's there in the syllabus also. Boundary controls, communication controls, input controls, database controls. Sir, like this four controls, now only I got to know, sir. Very good. Simple logic, sir. What is a boundary? Boundary is nothing but in cricket stadium, you know what is a boundary? It separates the audience and the players. Similarly, you are buying something on online website. Flipkart you are buying, Amazon you are buying. You say, check out. It will say, you are now being redirected to a third party website. That is a boundary. Forget that. Those of you who go to office, income tax, 26 years. When you click from income tax login, 26 years, it will say, we are redirecting you to an external website. That's a boundary. Correct? So boundary control is nowhere relating to that. Input control, for keying the data. Database control, storing the data. Only option is communication. Otherwise also, what does it speak about? Sending, receiving. Sending and receiving, what in our first standard they told, that is called communication. Right, the answer. I hope you remember it. This is what is called as educated guess. Think what is the most logical. One other question, this is again an application oriented question. Yes, no, can't say. Let's consider the controls. How many of them say control? How many of them say security? Something you should say. Yeah. How many of them say transaction? A few of them. How many of them say e-commerce? E-commerce is the answer. Simple. Sir, transaction is something not only. See, this entire model is, they promise that they will give you in 3 days. If they don't give it in 3 days, I obviously will cancel it. Why? Because it's an e-commerce transaction. If you had done it in a normal course, you would have gone to the shop and purchased it. That is why I said this is a confuser. You know, the bouncer, the googly. Correct? So this is that so-called googly. Alright? Let's quickly look into ISCA. The few sample questions, the entire thing you'll find it in the institute material. Sorry. ICA website, please take it up and click it. Yeah. Arrange in chronological order of their assessment. So they'll give these four and they'll give option A, B, C, D. B, C, A, D, C, A, B, D, you know, multiple options. I have not given the option, but I just thought I will check with you folks. What is the first one? Risk, threat, to vulnerability, impact. Vulnerability? What is vulnerability? Something which is inherent. So first you always assess the vulnerability. If vulnerability materializes, alright, vulnerability materializes, it becomes a risk. And that risk, if it is done by a third party, threat, and when the threat takes place, you have a impact. I hope you understand. Alright, so those of you who are doing CA final, you will find this in your first chapter where they talk about risk treatment. What is the first thing, what is the second thing, etc. Next, look at this. I am sure everybody will be able to answer this. Remember the educated choice option, common sense. The best definition to define a human being, first time we are defining human being. Correct, look at the beauty of our exam. And look at the commonality in this option. I'll tell you one more tip there. You will find all options will have everything common. There is one more tip for you. When you find more than two or three options with a common setup, try to see until what stage there is a commonality. Physical everything is a commonality. Probabilistic everything is a commonality. That means all the four are good options. Now when you come here, you realize automatically. Is human being automatic? No. Therefore, they remove. So that means I still have this. I have close, I have open, close and open. Are we close sometimes? Meaning, are we to ourselves? Yes. Do we speak to the world? Yes. Therefore, close and open. I was wondering how this became my information system test question paper. Anyway, I have an issue question paper. Next. One more sample area of last question maybe. BCP includes everything, various plans to be prepared. This includes all of those. Alright? Out of the four plans, which are the major part of the plan which should be executed before? The most important word is before. For the first, you should know what is the meaning of each of this. Emergency is what you do after the disaster occurs. When there is a fire, what you do? Fire, fire, you start shouting. Then immediately call for the police, you use the extinguisher, that's the emergency plan. Next, backup plan. If fire occurs, my data will get lost. Therefore, before the fire occurs, I will take the backup. Next, recovery. Will I recover before the fire? No, after the fire. And last is test. When will I test? After the fire came? Before the fire. Can I test my fire extinguisher when there is a fire? Oh wait, let me test it. I hope you are clear. That means what is the answer? Backup and test. Easy, logical, moral of the story, MCQs will ensure that you will 100% pass the examination. At least in a paper called ITSM and ISCA. Unless you get so confused and you yourself complicate it. Alright? The penultimate thing which I want to draw reference is order of preparation. Humble request, please follow. It has been tested, it has been done. Hundreds or rather thousands of students I have spoken to, they said that this approach is much better. Many of them have a strategy. Oh, first chapter I'll read first, second chapter I'll read second, third chapter I'll read third. No. Change the approach. Institute has its own reason why they have given it. We have our own reason why we will do this. If you are in EIS, your first chapter you have to prepare is chapter 3. It is the biggest and the largest chapter. Your entire concepts will get clear. After that you go to financial accounting, automated, and then you go to core banking, and last you go to emerging and commerce and technologies. Are you clear? If you are going to IT, again here, chapter 3 becomes your priority because there is a huge volume of technical information. Alright? And then comes your business information, BPA, business process management, and IT fundamentals. You might be thinking, sir, why IT fundamentals in the last? What I generally suggest is even if you go in the second also, it's okay. But if you do it in the last, it becomes a revision period. Order of preparation is ISCA. First chapter, do not read first. If you read that, you will leave CA course only. Forget ISCA paper. Reason is you will not be able to get the practical perspective. That's what I'm saying. First chapter, the reason why they kept it first, there is a lot of practical relevance. After you become a CA, I'll teach you that. But for becoming a CA, let's go on the most practical approach. Your priority is information system concepts. That should be the first chapter. And then remaining things which I have mentioned. Are you clear? So I am not spending too much time here. For want of time, I wanted to quickly go through. Alright, reference material, ICA material only, latest. Practice manual suggested. I think a new syllabus of EIS, you will not be having practice manual. It is all the more good for you, you have only one book to study. Alright, suggested answer by ICA. I think some suggested answers are out, some are not yet out. Please watch out in the website or you can check in the bookstore terms. Revision test paper by ICA. And one more unique thing which I want to make a mention. Institute has one beautiful publication called Chartered Accountant Students Journal, which comes to your post box every month and goes to the dustbin next month. By mistake, if you happen to open it, they give you the entire syllabus of 100, 200, 300, 500 pages in 20 pages. Alright? So, as of now, the only thing relating to EIS, I think it's missing over here because I not mentioned it. June 2018 student edition, please take it. EIS, you have revision material in 25 pages, it is there. It is a revision material, not the only material. Please be careful. So, 25 pages, you will read and go right there. Don't take chances. June 2000 ICA student material, if you visit the website, you will be able to get it. Alright? So, exam patterns, you guys should be aware. Now, this is going to change. This is going to change. I am only talking about the past pattern because now onwards you are going to have MCQs. Alright? So, question number 1 normally is a composite question, 10 marks. This is for the existing method. This would be replaced by MCQs. Alright? So, you can expect 2 marks, 4 marks, 6 marks, etc. Normally, this is an internal choice. Do not panic too much about this. If you look into IT also, it's more or less the same. And if you're looking into ISCA, your first question is a practical question. Practical question, they are just given some concepts and you have to draw a reference. An example of practical question, this is probably about a year or two back. BB Bank, you know, they speak about all facts and circumstances and they give you an entire case. From this only you'll be able to pick up few keywords. For example, it has ATMs, that means you are looking at bank, you know, it has something related to core banking, it has something called as, you know, business continuity. So these are the areas where they will test you. For example, what are the key management practices? What are the IT tools you consider? What is the requirement of IS audit as per RBI? What are the stages of PC? Alright, so that's how it is. Few important areas, this I will give it out as a separate material. You can pick it up from the institute branch because it's a fairly detailed one. Alright, so this is what I was telling you. You have technical concepts, for example, in old syllabus chapter 2 and 3, in new, whereas the common sense writing is chapter number 1. So like this, every syllabus has its own weightage. I'll also give you my email ID, you can write to me if you have any more clarification, I'll be happy to share this. So you know, these are a few important areas which I have mentioned it over point in time. This anyways, I'll publish it, I'll give it. So EIS new syllabus, again here technical concepts, chapter 3, process and accounting related concepts, chapter 1, 2 and 5, and management here, some topics in chapter 2. So it's all a mixture, combination. Okay, so as I noted, this entire thing guideline I'll give it to you so that it becomes handy. ISCA, again here, IT check, technical concepts, your chapter 5 is a pure technical concept, your chapter 8, emerging technology, is a purely technical concept. So one tip which I would suggest for ISCA students is, please take up EIS MCQ also and read. EIS and, what is that, IT, because some topics are overlapping. In fact, from CA final, they brought it to intermediate, because in the new scheme, they've removed ISCA. Right, so general management gyan, chapter 4, the easiest of the chapter, and the combination, for example, chapter 2, protection of information assets, etc. So these are a few important things. I'll not spend too much time, as I told, I'll give you this material. Exam answering strategies, answer which you know the best, very important, whichever you know the best, part A or part B, whatever it is. Read the question paper properly, very crucial. Give headings of all bullet points, wherever possible. Ensure there is sufficient space. This is one dangerous thing which I've seen. They write all the answers right next to each other. Leave half a page or leave or underline whatever is possible. And begin the answer by saying, answer to question number 1A, answer to question number 1B, and write them. Alright, so those are a few things. Common mistakes made. Look at this. So they ask the question, differentiate between data and information. So one method is write data and then write information. Correct? But what our students did, first they spoke about data, then they spoke about information, again they spoke about data, again they spoke about information, again they spoke about data, again about information. So whoever is evaluating, he found it difficult, so obviously he gave 1 mark. Actually all the points have been written. Alright? Already somebody does, did it like this. Can you see this? 1.5 mark being given, and half a mark also matters. Okay? Next. Difference between online and real-time processing, again I've just highlighted the keywords. So look at this, the student has written everything wonderful and you know how many marks was given? 0. You know why? Is this 1C or 1E? The student actually wrote 1E but it looks like 1C at 1 angle. So as well as not, this is 1C and therefore rejected. Moral of the story, improvise your handwriting. We are addicted to this. Now start getting addicted to this. Alright? Yeah, this is again an example to say that, you know, if there is no conceptual clarity, even if your presentation is very good, you will not get the marks. Okay, and yeah, this is another example, mobile computing, what are the major risks? Now look at this, the student has written all of them and she has been awarded 2 marks. She or he, I'm not sure. Handwriting looks reasonably neat, it could be she. Alright, so 2 marks was awarded. Alright, look at this, this is again totally not related, 0 marks. I'll quickly jump the gun. I'll move to an interesting analogy. 4 marker questions. Again, you know, paragraph wise, which is fine. But again, only 2 marks were given. Why? Inappropriate. So first they spoke about centralized, they spoke about decentralized, again they spoke about both. Correct? So this is typically, you don't know whether to choose curd rice or whether to use sambar rice. You mix both and write. Which is also the, what are the Chitrana type of answers. Right? Don't write both of them. I'll quickly jump the gun. The entire presentation is available online also. You can pick it up. I'll share the link for that. And They asked a very interesting question. What is the meaning of Android? Our fellows, you know Android, we have been using. Like, I don't know the definition. They wrote whatever they felt like. Obviously, you won't get the marks. When you use the word Android, they are looking at a few words. It's a Linux-based operating system. The word operating system is a crucial thing. It's not that I have Android, my friend has Android, my girlfriend has Android, no. Correct? You'll have to go for the core words. And 8 marks question, flowcharts. Alright, CA intermediate flowcharts, very very crucial. Learn, it is very simple, not complicated. It is very very simple. And they don't ask you programming flowcharts, it's very basic flowcharts. Alright, so this is one of the cases where they gave the steps and you were expected to draw a flowchart. You know what the answer was? Simple. First to start, n is equal to 1, print n into n minus 1, stop, correct, and go to n. Complicated? No. But our fellows will complicate. Sir, print should come last. How can print come second? Entire IT, SM, everything I learned, always print should come last. Therefore, our student got print in the last. Mass also got last. Correct? See? Everything is correct, but that why that print went to. Sir, print can happen anytime, sir. Blank sheet also you can print. Most of the time in office, that will give you. Correct? So you can print at anything. And look at the beauty over here, in case you observe. Every step has got a marks. Alright, flowchart, that's a beauty, and I'm sure in other subjects also faculties would be making mention of it. Alright? And beautiful flowchart. Yena pattern. Suddenly you have drawn something, you have corrected, suddenly you have corrected, then something and all you have done here. Correct? Thank you. If this is the case, strike it out and draw in a fresh sheet. Absolutely fine. Alright? Yeah, I think this is the basic things. I have not spent too much time there. Yeah, concluding remarks. I'll skip the done there. Alright, I'll quickly go there. Change in approach is the need of the hour. Whatever you follow for the 7 subjects, you cannot follow mutatis mutandis over here. You have to slightly tweak it. A chain is as strong as its weakest link. Remember, I keep on mentioning that this is one typical type of a paper. Alright, so life is much more larger than IT, ISCA and EIS. Don't get disappointed. It is just a entry point because there is a world of opportunities in just one subject. Alright, when I started my profession and I 5 years back or 5 to 8 years back, I knew very limited just like you folks. But I started reading and today I am one among the top international faculties or international speakers in this particular subject. Why? It is because of my sheer perseverance. And that is exactly what you guys will have to do. Do not think that this is a burden. Think that this is what is the practical reality. Alright? So keep calm, the exam is not strong. On that note, Anima, get set. All the very best. So these are my contact details. That's my blog. You can scan it. It will take me to the blog directly. I am available on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, social media. Online classes, if you feel that you want to hear me out, you can go here. Face-to-face classes, I teach at CAPS. And sometimes I teach at Institute as well. On that note, thank you so much all of you. It was a pleasure talking to you. Hope it was useful. If there are any questions, probably I'll take it offline. I think we'll quickly after all. Thank you.
Sir, as you rightly mentioned, approach will change a lot of things in life. This guy is nothing in front of that. Big round of applause once again. Request CA Panindra Gupta, Managing Director, Member of Management, to kindly come forward and as a token of appreciation and gratitude, I request him to kindly present a moment or two. CA Narasimhan Elangovan. Please round of applause.